Let's have a look at the schematic for the PID test rig. So first I'll go through just a quick note on how to read the schematic. If you're already a guru at reading these type of schematic, just bear with us for the people who are not such an expert. So if you look on the schematic up here, you see grid lines and numbers 1, 2, 3 to 8 and A to F along the vertical border there. So what that means is if you put an imaginary line straight through, all of this section here, this column would be 1, and another one between there and there would be 2, and so on over here would be 8. Put a horizontal line there, all of this row would be A, B, and F. Now if just like Excel or any other software like that, to find a particular location, which would be a cell, this would be 1A, 2A, 3A. If you have one here, that would be 1B. Down here would be that's 8F. If you have one here, 8C. You have a grid, let's say here, that would be 5C. Okay, so good enough there. Another thing to note is these on here we have these pentagons. These pentagons are used to depict notes, and for this we have the notes down here. So note number one is telling you how to connect the L298 motor driver. So connect in1 to in3 to 5 volts, in2 to in4 to ground. Note number two is telling you to connect both the 5 volt and 30 volt grounds together. And note number three is just giving an overview of what BPFB is, which is your ball position feedback. Another thing to note is a source and destination arrows. So right here you see this is a source arrow, which means this wire that's going through is continued at these destinations here in these grids. So 5E7A7D, if we go to E and go across the 5, we'll note that this 5 volt DC is coming right there. It's coming right there. If we go to 7A or 7A, which would be right here, we see that 5 volt DC coming there. And 7D, so 7 down to D, we see this wire coming in here too. Same for the ground, it goes to 5E and 7A. So 5E would be right here, right here, and 7A is right up there. Another thing to note about reading the schematic is wire numbers. So on here we have it formatted in the sheet number, which is that sheet 01. So 01 comes first, and 6E is actually the location on the schematic diagram. So that is in 6, that is in E, and it's the first wire that started in 6E. This one would be sheet number 1, 6 again, E, and it's the second wire started in that cell. Same thing over here. Yeah. So basically that's a quick overview. This schematic will be made available for whomever is interested. And yeah, just for an overview of the components here. So you got a 5 volt power supply, and it feeds your OLED display, it feeds your Arduino, it also feeds your potentiometer for setting your ball position. It also comes over here, it powers your ultrasonic sensor. That part of it goes to your motor driver there, and it comes to the boost converter also to step it up to 30 volts to run the motors. So yeah, that's a quick overview of just how to read this type of schematic. Other than that, this should be pretty straightforward. Just follow your wires and look at the wire numbers, and should be good. Thank you.